West Middle School HVAC upgrades, mechanical construction, Wolf's Plumbing and Heating.
The project consisted of two buildings, one built in 1953, the north, the other in 1962, the south. Neither one of the buildings had a central air conditioning system. The cooling that was available was handled with a few mini splits and some window shakers. The south building had an outdated hydronic heating system. The north building had a newer model of hydronic heating system, just not big enough for what was needed by both buildings. The RCAS board decided to replace the south building's hydronic heating system totally, updated the north building's HVAC equipment and accessories, and provide a chilled water system large enough to take care of both buildings. The system is comprised of a four pipe unit ventilators for the classrooms, which have ducted discharges in the south building classrooms. High efficiency condensing boilers provided water for heating, and a DX water chiller provides water for cooling. There are necessary unit heaters, exhaust fans, pumps, along with an automatic temperature control system to provide for a complete HVAC system. All water systems include a 30% inhibited propylene glycol solution. The project started in May of 2020 with an extremely aggressive schedule. To compound matters, it was apparent from the start that there may be problems getting equipment on time to meet the schedule. First, the bid date of April 15th left little time to get submittals prepared and approved so the equipment could be ordered. In addition, the COVID pandemic had crept into almost all aspects of the construction industry. Both manufacturing and shipping were slowed down considerably. Through a joint effort by suppliers, construction, and design teams, we were able to get all the equipment for inside the building ordered by mid-May. With anticipated ship dates that range from the first week of June to the last week of July, there wasn't much time left for installation, considering the completion date was August 17th. The actual construction got underway a couple weeks earlier than anticipated. Due to the shutdowns caused by the pandemic, staging of on-site infrastructure and storage, and the removal of existing heating equipment and piping systems started on May 4th. A lot of this pipe was in tunnels, and the boiler room was about 5 feet below the main floor. The boilers and existing expansion tanks were fairly large, so they had to be cut into small enough pieces to fit through the door. The guys built a trolley system to use for getting the parts from the sunken boiler room up to the main floor, where they used dollies to get things out onto the loading dock. This was not an easy project. New installation of piping had already started before the boiler room equipment was all removed. Removal of all the existing HVAC units, along with the cabinetry, was accomplished at the same time. There was a lot of classroom equipment computers that had to be protected during construction. There were several items that had to be addressed on the fly. There wasn't much time for investigating before deciding how to address issues. Both the owner and design engineer were very helpful in making this work. On June 5th, we found out that the manufacturer of the unit ventilators for the South Building had closed down due to COVID. This threw a monkey wrench into the project. After some help from another HVAC supplier, we came up with an alternate unit to order. This, of course, put the shipping date out farther than the original date anticipated. More reasons the job completion date was in jeopardy. All the ship dates, for the most part, were delayed due to COVID. We didn't receive the chiller until the third week of September. All that aside, the job went very smoothly for something so hectic. The workers all put in extra hours working together very well to get the system completed. They completed a very complex project in a very compressed time frame. They can all be very proud.
Master Craftsman Superintendent Scott Hartman, Mechanical Superintendent Slade Volk, HVAC Foreman Bruce Walby, Craftsman Rob Bennett, Jesse Culver, Eddie Frazier, Roger Gaynor, Case Gustafson, Craig Hopson, Wyatt Horn, Dawson Hoven, Mason Kiteforce, Woodrow Palmer, Zeb Palmer, Richard Rupp, and Kenton Voorhees. Help us congratulate the craftsmen from Wolf's Plumbing.